Hey guys, Kimber here, and welcome to Maize, a game about sentient corn. This game came out recently on Steam, and from what I've seen in the trailers, it looks hilarious, so I've decided to give it a go. Without further ado, let's get into it. There's no sound at the moment. There we go. Okay, that scared me. I'm glad this is not a horror game, or this would have probably been very terrifying. These graphics are amazing. Can we go into corn? No, we can't. Something gonna jump out at me in here. I hope it's on. This is just beautiful. I hope it's me making the noise. So is all the corn sentient, or just a few stalks? That's what I want to know. This is rather freaky if all of these are going to come to life. Okay, so that's the river we just saw. What's this? Okay, so we can't interact with these yet. But looks like we need an item of sorts. Something round, a helix, and a hand. I hope it's not a real hand we have to find. Okay, so there's a house over here. Okay, so that opens the menu. There's a big silo over there. Oh, it looks like we're in a maze. It's dead ends now. Pressing Q does absolutely nothing. It doesn't. It appears to be correct because it's not doing anything. Not sure I should trust it though, so I'm still gonna press Q on occasion just to see if it does anything. Okay, we've got a folio item. How do we access this? Alright, so I just looked at the controls quickly, and it's spacebar. A note lazily scribbled includes a stock greeting and encourages the reader to enjoy the complimentary snack on the desk. Notes to the reader to mind the boxes and also says open the big door and will probably say hello. Alright, let's see if we can find the big door. What's this thing? I got an English muffin and a new path has opened to me, apparently. I wonder where this will be. English muffin. Hard as granite, this muffin is most definitely nowhere near fit for consumption, despite how much you try. All you've done is given yourself a headache. Okay, so I've got an English muffin now. This is a nice spot. Okay, so there's a windmill this way. Oh. Oh, we had to mind the boxes, he said, so I guess we can't go through this way. No. We have to come back later. This is just beautiful, the graphics. So now it tells me how to look at my folio. That looks like the elevator door we couldn't get in earlier. Let's go this way before we check out the house. Oh, what's this thing? A shovel handle. Broken shovel handle. Completely useless for shoveling dirt, but helpful if you wanted to tip something over. You immediately think of the wardrobe on the second floor of the farmhouse because you didn't particularly like how it looked at you and would like to ruin its day. I haven't been in the house yet, but I'm guessing there's something upstairs for that then. We can't go to the windmill this way either, it's also blocked off. Wonder who this guy is. There's no inscription on the trunk. No, guess we'll find out later. I guess we can have a look around the house then. Let's see if we can go around back first. There's something there. I can't get to it though. There's another path over here. Let's take a look here first. Open the chicken coop door. Something in the chicken coop? Ooh, a key. Farmhouse key. Oh, we probably needed to come get this before we could go inside anyway. Let's take a look down here. No matter how many times you press in Q, still does nothing. I actually was pressing Q, so that's pretty cool. Can't use that. Oh wait, we didn't examine the farmhouse key. Your mind explodes at the possible uses of this item, but you settle on key to unlock a nearby farmhouse and never think of any other possibility again. Is this a rock? Folio item. A mediocre rock. This is a rock you found near an outhouse. You don't know why you have it. It is absolutely mediocre in every way possible. Its name is Chauncey. Alright then. You're coming with me then, Rock. We're going on an adventure together. So I'll have to come back for this. I don't think anything gets this out. Do your work, English muffin. I think that's most of the outside stuff that I can reach at the moment. So let's just finish our loop of the farmhouse and then we'll go inside. Wonder if anyone's gonna be home. Looks like there's no one here, but never know until we get there. What's that thing? Looks like a giant donut. Okay, so the road to there is blocked off, so don't need to go down there. So let's try go inside. Here we go. Is there anything on the porch I missed? Nope. Can we turn on the lights? Nope. Dark in here. Good, things light up white, makes it a bit easier to see. Invoice for a carved wooden statue. Invoice for a commissioned wooden statue. Cost is in the hundreds of thousands. Items on the list include chopping down a large old oak tree, carved statue out of oak tree, and hospital bills for injuries sustained while chopping down oak tree. There's so much random stuff, I love it. Let's finish downstairs before we go upstairs. A really boring mystery novel. Having no talent at the genre, the author mistakenly revealed the murderer's identity on the first page and spent the rest of the novel outlining a story about the detective buying a pair of pants. Night Danger, a Mick Murphy mystery. That would be an interesting book to read. Oh, we're gonna swing at this. Okay, I have a fruit crate. Despite what the name would suggest, this crate was specifically used to hold a large number of pine cones in order to start a collection. The collection currently sits at zero. Oh, we can take a plug. Does that go in here? Yes, it does. But what do I do with it now? I guess we don't have the things for that yet. What's this thing? Sausage grinder. Something is jammed inside. I don't think my English muffin and items are gonna help here. What's this? Rancid corn oil. Can we tip this in the sink? Yes, we can. The smell is worse than imagined. What do we do now? Can I put my muffin in it? No. I guess we'll get back to that. Storage room. Oh wait, something down here. Proceed to crouch and see again to not crouch. You can do this forever. This guy's got some serious leg muscles. Unlock secret door, making it much less secret. You want to explore the rest of the house first, or... yeah, let's just get in here first. Lovely place. Oh, what's this? Fuse box, missing a fuse. So I need a fuse for that one. Is there anything else down here? I don't see anything. There's another stair. But that's it. Where does the stair go? Oh, that's the latch. We're back outside now. Let's just go back in and we'll keep exploring the house. So there's nothing else down here except the fuse box. So we'll get back to that later. Yeah, let's go upstairs. Oh, this must be that cupboard the handle was talking about. It looks like our fruit crate goes here. Here we go. Can we use this on here? There we go. Ah, so that's what I needed a fruit crate for. Although I think that would break before it tipped this, to be honest. We'll go across there in just a sec. Let's explore the rest of the upstairs first. I hope that's not blood. This is not supposed to be a horror game. So many boxes in the bathtub. Doesn't seem to be anything else in here. Something over here. A bobby pin. Extremely useful for picking a lock, but you mistakenly thought it was a pencil and wrote a very detailed account of your day up to that point, and didn't notice there was no ink until a few hours later. What are we playing? Is this just a really stupid person? I guess we'll find out later. That's a nice picture. Is there nothing else up here? No, I can't pick that up. Okay, it's time to cross the cupboard in, I guess. Thought that something moved for a second. Another story. Oh, it's a mess up here. Oh, there's something on the desk. A mallet. Smash something perfectly flat with this trusty tool. But remember, you can never unflatten things with this thing. It is the mallet's greatest weakness. There's an item that can be placed there, but I don't have anything of that shape, I'm pretty sure. No. Still got my trusty English muffin. or something. A burnt lab report. Much of it can't be read, but the words abject failure appear several times. So does hurt feelings, sentient corn stalks, and why did we do this? That's a very good question. Why did you do this? So is there nothing else up here? So let's see what we have. We got a mallet, a bobby pin, and an English muffin. So let's go see what we can do with those. So we unlocked this earlier. We've already been this way, but let's just take another look now. We've got some different items. Been in there, but there was nothing to do. We still have nothing for that door we saw earlier. No, we still can't pull out the nail, and there was nothing else here, so let's just go back. Might have missed a path in the corn maze somewhere. Well, I have no clue where I'm supposed to go at the moment, so I'll save you watching me wandering around aimlessly for God knows how long, and I'll be back as soon as I find something. Hey guys, we're back. I spent quite a long time just wandering around, not able to find what I was supposed to do next. But now I found this cabinet I'd missed earlier, which had some nail clippers in it. Vigilant as you are when it comes to personal hygiene, the only two things these clippers will do for you are grip something lodged in a wall and give you 100% tinnitus guarantee. That's it. Well, we know where there's something lodged in a wall. That's in that outhouse behind the chicken coop. So we finally have another point to go forward with. Then I have a nail, which I can try to do something with. I've still been pressing Q on occasion, but no other messages have popped up so far, so I don't think it's gonna do anything. There we go. For some reason, the first thing that pops into your head is that it would be a good conductor of electricity, possibly as a fuse. You are very strange. Well, strange as whoever I'm playing may be. At least I know what to do with the nail now. Let's go bring it to the basement. I wonder what that will actually do. Maybe the lights will come on, but how does that help us? Is there like another item we can see? Let's just put it in and take a look what happens. I hadn't noticed that before, but that's an interesting portrait. Oh well, let's see what this does. Oh, here we go. Restore tower to farmhouse. It is slightly less dark than it was before. Yeah, it is lighter. I don't see anything new glowing in here, so let's head back upstairs. Nothing's changed in here. I don't have anything for pulling that thing out yet. I hear a noise. Oh, here it is. What's this? CD player. Picked up a CD. Good for you. A new passive opened to you. The barn and silo. An old CD. Its label faded. Pressed on the first batch of CDs ever created, this brand was notoriously expensive and even more unreliable, making even the greatest of symphonies sound like something a concussed elephant would make while stumbling around a music shop. I love the descriptions in this game, they're amazing. So the barn and the silo, I'm guessing that's this way. Yeah, the boxes are gone. No, I can move faster now. That's nice when I'm wandering aimlessly, having no clue where to go. Yep, I know all my equipped items at the moment. I just need to see what's in here to see if I can combine them in any way. Nothing in there. Here's something. A book titled Corn of the World. A book outlining the differences and similarities of corn species across the globe. Several chapters also discuss the color yellow. A few species are circled in red pen, while no, no, no appears in many places across the entire book in blue pen. So someone was marking things with corn species. I wonder which species the sentient corn was made from. Oh, there's a broom. There's a pile of something or other you can sweep up with this, but you already knew that. What you didn't know was that this broom is haunted. This will not affect your adventure in any way, as the ghost is currently away on business. Okay, so I've got a broom. What's this thing? One half of a diagram. Diagram torn in half contains very complicated little equations scribbled in orange pen. A drawing of a person and a DNA helix. Looks very important. You tried to eat it at first, but changed your mind when you couldn't find any salt. I need to get used to these buttons. What's this? Ew, it's a hand. It's full of straw. It's not a real hand. It looks like a scarecrow hand. Question mark, bad, and good. What's this poster? Get pumped. Interesting poster to hang in a barn. Nothing here. Let's take a look back this way. Is there something we could sweep down here that I missed? No, I don't see anything I could sweep up with the broom. I don't think I can use any of my other items here. Oh, the CD might actually work on that door we found at the start. It needed something round. Unless the English muffin fits in there. Okay, let's go this way. Wait, what's over here? The silo! Padlock. Can we use our lockpick on this? There we go. At least something we can sweep, so let's do that first. I got a needle-nose pliers. You saw something in that sausage grinder that could be removed with those pliers. You know this because you spent an uncomfortable amount of time trying to pull it out of your hands, making no progress whatsoever. Old telescope. Oh, it's a folio item. Manufactured about a century ago, this telescope's effective range is tops of low-hanging trees, possibly because its lenses were put on backwards. Looks like it was used frequently with varying results. And it's a blueprint. Though it's hard to make out, this blueprint looks like it's for the construction of a very large and very poorly planned facility, with a farm situated on top of it. The facility itself actually sets an architectural record for having the largest number of corridors that lead absolutely nowhere. Okay, so that facility's below us, I'm guessing? And I'm hoping that that maze is not something we're gonna have to go through, because I am not good at mazes. I don't think there's anything else in here. So let's go down that other path. I wasn't pressing Q anymore, I'd already stopped game. What is this thing? Oh, this dead person. You're... Well, you got zapped pretty bad. Oh god, can I take his hand? Yes. Well, I've got a hand now. A severed hand, perfectly preserved in the glove that encases it. It could come in handy. Great pun. If you could give yourself a hand and find a way to loosen and get that glove off. The first pun was intended, but not the second. Oh, there's more stuff here. Can I get here? Oh, yeah. Fedora is a folio item. A very fashionable fedora worn by a very fashionable person. Due to this, you are not putting it on your head, as you have not earned the right. On the inner tag, the owner wrote his name, Fernando. Okay, what's this? A name tag. It took you several hours of steering, but you managed to deduce that the name tag in fact belongs to the dead person who was near, and that his name is Fernando. It took you several more hours to notice that the dead person was a lab assistant, and then 5 more minutes to realize you were trying to read the whole thing upside down the whole time. Our person's not very smart, I have to say. But there's a little box here. Whoops, wrong button. Can't jump in this game. Nope, can't anything at the little box. Can't do anything of him, so I guess we go get this hand off. Did it say how we got the hand off? Need to loosen it. Maybe that sink we couldn't do anything with? Let's give that a go. We can also get the sausage grinder while we're in here. Let's get the sausage grinder first. I just need to move around this way. Pulled warp key fob. Not an ideal place for it. This warped key fob will be useful if you could flatten it back to its original shape. At first you tried to do this by steering very hard at it. It didn't work. So you set out to find a tool that will do the job much better. Well, I've got a mallet that would probably do it. Let's see if this works. Yes! Slightly disgusting, yes. Once you manage to tear away from giving yourself an unending stream of high fives at his hand, you may want to find an actual use for it, and it's not to start another round of high fives. We can use this to open the door. The key fob had a DNA symbol on it, but it needs to be flattened for that. Where would we see the hammer again? Oh, we've got the hammer with us. Where will we use it, though? Let's try upstairs. There was a spot I could put something down, I remember. But where was it? I think it was here. Yes, here it is. Here we go. Now can I use my hammer? There we go. This key fob has been smashed so perfectly flat that you can't help but toss it like a frisbee to see how far it goes. You regret your decision immediately. Okay, so I've got, I think, all the items I need for that door now. If the CD fits, it should be all 3. Because it's definitely the hand and the key fob thing. So let's head back to the door. Go away, core noises. I don't want you here. Oh wait, that was the dead end. We need to go this way. These noises are still freaking me out. I'm scared something's gonna jump at me any second. Just see the CD. Alright, so I've got all items for the door, so I'm gonna end the video here, guys, and we'll open this door and see what happens next time. I'm Kimber, and I'll see you in the next video. See you later!